What is bookmark in Power BI? Hi, I am M. Masif Hussain from KnowHow Academy. In this video, we are going to see what is meant by bookmark and how to create a bookmark in Power BI. So let's start working on it. Rather than directly showing you the complete bookmark in Power BI desktop, let me give you some general way and general explanation how well we can understand bookmark before we start working on Power BI desktop. So I can call bookmark as a specific page. Okay. So whether the information that you would like to see from a whole report in the easiest way, that is one way of explanation. The second way, if I would like to talk about, if you would like to see some specific categorical information, or if you would like to see some specific information on the overall report which you would like to see in a unique perspective, this is then also we can create a bookmark. So it is a specific page. So let me give you a general example that we all might have encountered in our day-to-day life. Is one thing is that online e-commerce shopping. Okay, so in the e-commerce shopping, most probably the important thing is that we have a home page. Let us consider Amazon. Okay, we have Amazon, we have Flipkart, and we have Myntra. Like in India, we have a lot of different e-commerce platforms. So if we generally consider the Amazon website, okay, Amazon.com. So in Amazon website, if we go and see in a home page, there will be lots and lots of products which are visible, right? Irrespective of filtering. Again, I'm repeating. Irrespective of filtering, we have many such products that are visible in the home page, right? So kitchen appliances, clothing, electronics, shoes, you know, furnitures, etc., etc. So we have a lot of things that are displayed in a home page. But so let me give you some the clear explanation. So this is the home page of Amazon, right? So in this home page of Amazon, we have multiple things. So irrespective of any filtering, so we have some clothing, we have some electronic items, we have some automotive essentials. So in this way, we have lots and different kinds of products that are clearly placed and visible in the home screen. Now the point is that, is it really worthy? Is it really time-saving process if I start scrolling down and check whether whichever product I would like to purchase? You know, is it really worthy to scroll down and go through what exactly the product that I'm looking for? No, it takes a lot of time. It is waste of time, right? So what I have to do, I have to filter it out. So for example, if I would like to go and purchase some clothing, yeah, I have to purchase some clothing. Then again, in clothing also there are categories, right? Kids clothing, men clothing, women clothing. So again, so which type of clothing? T-shirts, shirts, or pants, trousers, joggers, what? So there are a lot of categories. So if I come here, there is something called a specific page. You know, we call it as a menu option where we have all here. So under this, if I would like to drop down and see men's fashion. So again, in men's fashion, we have a lot of types of clothing, right? So clothing, t-shirts, shirts, jeans, innerwears, and so on. So if I click on shirts, then thus only the men's shirts details will be visible in my required result set. Am I right? So this is nothing but the filtering that I have done here. It is nothing but a specific page. This is a bookmark that they have created. Okay, so this is the bookmark that they have created. So from in the same way how Amazon have created a specific page, a bookmark for every individual products and category, we can also create a same bookmark for our report. I have a report here in my data set. So in this particular report, if we see, there are multiple visuals. So let me talk about the information called region. So we have four types of regions. So we have central, we have east, we have south, and we have west. There are four different types of regions. Now, if I would like to see only the central information, so what I have to do, I need to select this slicer, I need to click on central, then everywhere I am getting only the central information. So in the same way, if I would like to go and find out east, then I have to click on east. In the same way for south and west. So now what I'm going to do, I'm creating a bookmark. Okay, so now for example, if I come to west, I have come to West in, and in every filter I am getting the West information. Let me consider. So when I get every information of West region, again I have to go back to my original report where no filter should be applied. Okay, so how should I do that? So again I have to open my slicer. So now everywhere I am able to see only the West region. So I have to open the slicer again, disable this select that I have done, unselected, then I'm getting my original complete report back, right? So rather than avoiding these many steps, you know, very simple thing that we can do is create a bookmark. Okay, so how to create a bookmark, that let us find out. So under the view section we have something called as bookmarks. So click on bookmark and we have an option called add. I did not apply any sort of filter here, so let me consider this particular report as a home page. Okay, so I'm clicking on add. Bookmark one is created. Now let me rename it. I will rename it to home. So this will be my home page. Okay, so again I am doing the slicer, I'm just selecting the slicer, I'm clicking on central information. So in every visual I'm getting only the central information, right? So now I'm going to add another bookmark and I am marking this particular bookmark name as central. Now again let me disable this central and I'll click on east. So as soon as I click on east, in every visual I am getting the east information. I am clicking on add. Now I am making this bookmark as east. I am renaming it to east. So now let me remove this slicer with east, then let me select south. I want to apply the slicer for south. So in every visual I am getting the south information. So let me apply the slicer, let me apply this bookmark for south information. I am clicking on add and I am renaming this particular bookmark to my south, because I have this south information here. So again now I am just unselecting this south and let me click on west. So in every visual I am able to see the west region information. So let me mark this particular bookmark as west. I am renaming it to west. Now let me show you how this particular bookmark will be helpful. Now I have created 5 bookmarks. One is for home, second is for central, third one is for east, fourth one is for south, and fifth one is for west. Now I am in the west informations, right? So the total sales for west is 725.46k, the total profit for west is 108.42k, the total customers in the west region are 686, and these are all my informations. Now the point is that I want to come back. So rather than unselecting something from the slicer, let me click on home. As soon as I click on home, I'll get my complete report back. If I want to see only central information, I will click on central information. So in every visual, I'll get the central information. It is like a button. It is like a specific page. It is like a specific information that you are sorting out and just checking from it. So I'm coming back to my home. A bookmark can be created in this way. Now you might have a question, should we create a bookmark only for a slicer? No, a bookmark can be created for any visual also. That is also possible. If you want to create a bookmark for any specific visual, yes, we can create a bookmark for it. So a bookmark plays a very important role when we are creating a report and start sharing this to the client or customer. So whenever they would like to sort out and figure it out some specific information from an entire report, then this bookmark will easily be helpful for them in order to find out the specific information. So that's where bookmark plays an important role. So this is how a bookmark to be created using Power BI Desktop. So thank you for choosing KnowHow Academy as your source for IT knowledge. We are always here to help you to navigate the tech world. If you have any questions, do not hesitate to reach out. It's been a pleasure sharing this information with you. Stay curious and keep learning.